It has been proposed to set up this industrial development corporation as distinct from the industrial credit corporation. I am not concerned at present with the latter. Sir, the object of this corporation is stated to be to quicken the pace of industrial development in the country. There is no denying the fact that it is necessary for the government to take the initiative in the matter of industrial development of our country and help in the growth of industries. If money were required for this purpose, nobody would be more happy to provide that money than our party, because we stand for the industrial development of the country. But what is being done in the name of development of industry is this. The government is making over certain things to the big men in the business and is entirely leaving matters to them and is relying on them for the development of the industries. In this scheme too, you will find the same attitude being taken by the government. I am not opposed to the idea of any consultation with competent persons, but at the same time, I would like to stress that it is all the more necessary to consult, for instance, the representatives of the workers and the representatives of the consumers, members of parliament, and other men in the public field in order to get their advice in the matter. Instead of doing so, government consults only the big monopolists who naturally offer their advice with a certain bias into which we need not go. It has appeared in the press that after developing certain industries under the aegis of the Industrial Development Corporation, such industries may be made over to private capitalists again. That is to say, government will start these industries at a time when the risk is great. Government will put in its money and take all the risk, and after development, these industries may even be made over to private industrialists and private enterprise. I think that this is entirely wrong. It is necessary for the government to develop industries and widen the public sector. There is no doubt about it, but it would not be right in this situation today to develop these industries in order to make them over to private individuals. If they are developed by government, they should be kept in the public sector as far as possible. We have our misgivings because we feel that these gentlemen of the big money would be interested in getting some of the industries started by the government at the cost of the public exchequer, when the risk will be entirely for the government to take. Then when these industries are on their legs, the industrialists will demand that they be made over to them as private concerns. This kind of logic is being introduced into this matter, and therefore I say that this is not a right thing to set about this business in this manner. This will not quicken in any way the industrial development of our country. On the contrary, it may lead to greater dependence on these people who are withholding the industrial progress of the country. I have in mind the monopolist section who is interested more in profit, more in quick money than in the development of the country. They are not interested in taking risk for the development of our industries, but are interested in seeking that the risk is shouldered by the government and that the gains to go them. When government asks for funds, they should explain to us what exactly is there in their mind. The reports that had appeared in the press are shrouded in mystery. We can understand that when these gentlemen talk with these big men, there is a certain amount of mystery about it. When we, the parliament, are called upon to make provision for funds, I think it is duty of the government to tell us what exactly they propose to do with the Industrial Development Corporation which they are going to set up. What will be its functions? How will it be administered? What will happen to the industry that will be started, and how would the selection be made? They will also have to tell us as to who will make the selection and which interest would be taken into consideration when the selection is made. How will the rights and wages of the workers be guaranteed in those industries which may be started under the aegis of the corporation? These दीज आर आल वेरी लेजिटिमेट एंड पर्टिनेंट क्वेश्चन फॉर अस टू आस्क एंड आई थिंक दैट द गवर्नमेंट शुड थ्रो सम लाइट ऑन देम. देयर इज अनदर आइटम ऑफ मेकिंग प्रोविजन फॉर डेलीगेशंस दैट आर गोइंग अब्रोड. आई हैव इन माइंड द डेलीगेशन वाट वॉज सेंट टू द गेट. वी सेंट अ डेलीगेशन टू दैट कॉन्फ्रेंस सर एंड अबाउट रुपीज 62,000 इज वॉन्टेड फॉर मीटिंग द कास्ट ऑफ दैट डेलीगेशन. वी हैव समथिंग टू से ऑन दिस आइटम विदाउट डिस्कसिंग फर्दर.